Welcome back, everyone. In this episode, we do the final assembly of the Enterprise Future Variant. Okay, now, we're just about done here. In order to get all the formation lights working properly, I had to change out the resistor here, just like I had to in that one. So I got a 10 ohm resistor in there before it was a 1K. Now all the formation lights work beautifully, and I rewired it again. Let's just do one more quick test before connecting the halves. It's always good to test and test and test and test and test, even before you put it all together. Otherwise, you'll end up having to crack open your model again and again, and you don't want to do that. All right, power source. Yep, the green, yellows, reds, they're all flashing beautifully. Not bad. Looks good. Okay. The only reason that the main lighting here is flashing, obviously, is because these are taking juice. It's just my batteries here are running low and can't keep the power requirements up. Once I have fresh batteries, it shouldn't really do that much anymore. It all comes down to the amperage. So, engineering hulls are ready to put together now. And I already checked it just by holding it down here and make sure all the lighting for the windows here is pretty good, and it looks very, very sexy. So it's just a matter of these here. I decided against putting in extra holes here for the stand. I'm just going to make a free stand for it. That's all I'm going to do. You can see in here where the wires are coming in. I have to gouge out a small section here. You can barely see where I, let's just get this. There we go. And where I marked it here, where I have to gouge it out just a little bit, just to make enough room for the wires. Otherwise, this bottom part here is not going to go down all the way flush. So I got to do that on both sides. All right. I'm just going to use a drill, just gouge it out. One more thing I have to do before these halves can be connected. I gotta make sure that the connection points here are gonna work with these points up here to power up the primary hull. Thank you. Nice tight fit. Mama. Very good, boys and girls. There we go. That's good for that. Looks good. Not bad. Alright. Time for those. Alright. So I just need to connect these all up now. This in here is the faster flasher. Which is this one. So this has to go over here to this point here. It's going to be long enough? Yeah, I think so. This is the main line, which will go on here. This is here. Go here onto this flasher, which is this one here. Yeah. All right. Now we got hooked up there. And those lights going there, and then we got this one here for the bridge flashing light going to the circuit there, and then these other wires here going to the main lighting over here. Now let's just do a quick test and see how it looks. Not bad at all. This one's ready to be put together. Alright, there we go. Just gotta let that all set now, and then, yeah. Okay, now we see here, looks good, it's holding. Thud. So it looks really well, looks really nice at all. Oh yeah. One sexy ship, man. Now, for this in here, I'm not going to take that off yet because I still have to do a little bit of work here. So I got to add a bit more adhesive in this area here. Then I'm going to use the contour putty so it'll cover all of this area up, and then it'll be ready, and I can take this stuff off, and then it'll officially be ready to go. And then, in the next episode, we're going to be working on all of these. Okay, now in here, I put the contour putty in the connection areas here, and once I let that dry, I will paint it the hull color, and it should mesh right in. Okay, I got that done here. I used some Gorilla Glue. It's thick enough, and I kind of built this up area here up a little bit. Because there's still windows there that would have been covered over. And because the Gorilla Glue is clear, the light will still get through the windows. And then, and then, after that, once it's all set, I will do the contour putty. And then repaint it. Boom. Done. Finished. Alright, there we go. So I got that all done now. The whole thing here is done. Just gotta do a light check later on. If there's any bleed through along the edges here, it's easy enough. I just put a darker colored paint along the edges there, and it's taken care of. Next, I'm gonna put on the impulse engine cowlings. Test. Make sure I got them set properly. Yeah, that's good. That's good. 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 There's evidently light bleed through in some of the cracks along the edges here, but that's easy enough to fix, so I'll take care of that. Okay, this upper hull here is almost ready for the body deckling. Lower hull here is ready, but I'm going to wait till I have the primary hull here finished before I start on any of the deckling for the body. It's going to take a few days to apply all of the deckling, because I can only do so much, and then I have to let it dry, and you know, it can't all be done in like 2 hours. I mean, it's many, many hours yet to go. That's it for this episode, folks. The next one, we're actually going to start on the main Aztec deckling for the ship. So if you have any questions or you want me to do some commission work for you, you can contact me at modelbuilder501@yahoo.ca. Please like, subscribe, and comment. Catch you guys again later. Bye-bye.